mood is I be loaded. Why you watch her drinking 40s? I just told it. Still that same nigga in a foreign, but it's stolen. Ryan sporty, I can sport it, can't control it.
Yo, what's up YouTube? It's your boy Smeekwell, and in tonight's video, we are going to be finding out who the best three-point shooting center is in the NBA today. This is only going to be current players. If we did old players, there'd just be too many people. So we're going to be using current players and checking out who all is going to be in this contest. We got DeMarcus Cousins, Karl-Anthony Towns, Marc Gasol, Joel Embiid, Brooke Lopez, Mike Muscala, Jason Smith, Al Horford, Pau Gasol, Frank Kaminsky, Kelly Olynyk, Thon Maker, and Maurice Spate. So these are the top rated best three-point shooting centers in the game. And we're going to find out who is actually the best. So in order to do this, we're going to be putting them in a three-point contest. Going to be playing on Superstar difficulty. And what we're going to be doing is going to be doing 10 shots per center from five different spots on the three-point line. Whoever makes the most is going to win this competition. It has to be a good release in order for it to count, unless it's a poor release and it goes in. So we're going to be starting off with DeMarcus Cousins here. And guys, before we start this thing off, go check out my second channel. Going to be making a second channel. We're almost at 800 subscribers. Go subscribe to that. Going to be doing reactions and vlogs on there. So definitely go check that out. Anyways, let's start off with DeMarcus Cousins here. See what he can do. He gets a perfect release on his first two shots. He is 2 for 2. DeMarcus Cousins starting off good here. We get a slightly early release, so we have to redo that one. It has to be a good release for it to count. And DeMarcus Cousins misses his first shot. He is 3 for 4. DeMarcus Cousins with 3 points. He misses that shot again. So he is down. He has 3 misses now. 3 for 6. 4 shots left in this. He hits a slightly early release. Let's see if he can continue here. 2 more shots down. He's up to 5 points. Final 2 shots here. He has 5 points. Can he hit 6 shots here? Last shot, and he cannot hit it. So DeMarcus Cousins ends up scoring 5 points on this three-point contest. Right, you got 5? Yeah. Alright, so DeMarcus Cousins with 5 points. That is going to be the points to beat. We're up with Karl-Anthony Towns next. It's going to take a while to do this. We have quite a few players. Karl-Anthony Towns, perfect release on his first shot. Second shot, another perfect release for Karl-Anthony Towns. He is in his cold spot now though. Still managed to hit it. And he is 3 for 4, starting off very strong, just like DeMarcus Cousins did. DeMarcus Cousins didn't end too well, though. I don't know what it is about that right corner that makes it easier to hit those greens. But Karl-Anthony Towns with another 2 misses. Not looking too good at the end here. There we go. 4 points. See if he can get 5 here. No, he misses that shot. So he has to get 2 shots in on the final rack. That was above the line, so that one's not going to count. He is on fire from this corner. He is up to 5 points, and this is for the lead. Karl-Anthony Towns cannot hit it, so DeMarcus Cousins and Kat are all tied up with 5 made shots. Let's see what Marc Gasol can do. Also, leave a comment down below who you think is going to win. I think I forgot to mention that at the beginning. So Marc Gasol starting off here goes 1 for 2 on the first rack. Let's see what he can do on the second rack. Slightly early, so we're going to have to redo that shot. There we go. That's a good release, but he still misses. Slightly early again. He hits that, though. So Marc Gasol is up to 2 points in total here. Make that 3. He has shot 50% so far, and he gets another one. He's up to 4 points, shooting really good right here. Can he get 5? That's slightly early, so we're going to redo that. Misses that again, and another shot. He hits it. So Marc Gasol is up to 5 points here. Let's see if he can hit a 6th point. He misses that shot. His final shot for the win. No, he has 5 points yet again. It is all tied up between our first 3 centers, all hitting 5 points, but we got Joel Embiid taking the court next. Let's see what he can actually do. See if he can maybe win this thing. Joel Embiid starting off here. First shot is good to go. Second shot is good to go as well. Joel Embiid 2 for 2. A lot of these guys starting off very good, but not finishing strong. I don't know what it is about that first corner, but Joel Embiid is now 2 for 4, and he is in a hot spot here in the middle. See if he can hit these two shots. He's up to 3 points. That was slightly early, but he still hits it. He's up to 4 points. He might actually be able to win this. Another hot spot. Oh, that goes in and out. Unlucky for him. For 5 points, he cannot get it. So he has to hit at least one shot here to tie, and two shots to actually win this. This is to tie at 5 points. And Joel Embiid only gets 4. Started off very good. Didn't end the best. We're on to our next center, and it is going to be Brook Lopez. The goal to beat is 5. Hopefully somebody can beat it. Otherwise, we're going to have a tiebreaker at the end here. So first shot for Brook Lopez. He gets that to go. He has a hot spot in this corner. Hits both of those shots. And no hot spot on the second rack, but he does manage to hit it 3 for 3 so far. And he can't hit the fourth one. So 3 points in total. And he is on it to a cold spot here. This isn't going to be good for him. If he can hit one here, it'll be huge. He is on 3 points. Make that 4 points. Brook Lopez straight killing it. Another hot spot for him, but he can't convert on his first shot. Second shot is another miss. So again, he needs 2 shots at the end here to take the W. Gets a perfect release up to 5 points for the win. It is slightly early, so we get to redo that shot. Lucky for him. And he misses it anyway. So our Brook Lopez, 5 points. It is a 4-way tie right now. Somebody has got to beat them. All right, we got Mike Muscala up here next. Let's see what he can do. First rack for him in the corner. He hits his first shot. His second shot is good as well. He's 2 for 2, starting off strong, just like everybody else does in that corner. But he is 3 for 3. Make that 4 for 4. This man is going off right now. Can he keep hitting these shots? Come on. Can he get 5 in a row? He gets 5 shots in a row. Already tied with the top score. Only halfway through this. Slightly late release, so he gets to redo that. And he misses his 6th shot. He just needs 1 more shot to take the lead here. Misses yet again. Can it go in? No, another miss. 2 more shots to take the lead here. He just has to convert 1. And he will be winning this. He misses yet again. Come on, he is choking hard here. He hits his first 5 shots. And can't hit anymore. There we go. There's number 6 in the bucket. So Mike Muscala is going to be in the lead here with 6 points. Up to Jason Smith next. What is Jason Smith going to put down today? Will he be able to get 6 as well? Hot spot on this first rack here. He hits his first shot. And his second shot is good as well. 2 for 2 so far for Jason Smith. Can he keep on going? 3 shots in. And he misses his 4th shot, but he still has 3 points, which is very good. Halfway to the lead, tie for the lead here. Misses that shot. And this is for 4 points. Can't convert it. So 4 shots left to get, 3 points? That one was slightly late. That was another slightly early one. So he still has 2 shots on this rack. There we go. Hits that shot. That was super deep, but he still manages to hit it. He's up to 5 points. 1 more point to tie for first, and he does it. Can he win? Can he get 7 points? He cannot. Again, tied for that first place. Nobody can beat that 6 points. Up next, we got Al Horford, though. I think we're over halfway done this thing so far. It's pretty good. Al Horford up next here. Oh my gosh, his shot is so much different than everybody else's. Still manages to hit that first shot, though. Second shot is no good. He shoots it so slow and weird. 3rd shot, another miss. There we go. Perfect release. Al Horford up to 4 points. Can he keep going? Slightly early, but it still drops up to 3 points. Again, slightly early, but he hits it again. He's up to 4. He is straight killing it right now. Can he keep on going? Just for 5. And he sinks that. Didn't even give me a release there, which was kind of weird. So 1 more point to tie for first. He's got to hit both these to win it. There we go. He misses that shot. And can he tie for first? He does with a slightly early release. 6 points for Al Horford. So we got three people tied in first place yet again. Who's up next? Pau Gasol is up next. Can he finally get a lead? Can somebody have a lead and get seven here? Pau Gasol. Let's see what he can do. Oh my gosh, that was a terrible release. That was a terrible release. There we go. Good release there. So he gets his first shot in. Again, it does have to be a good release for it to count. Pau Gasol is 2 for 2. Can he beat his brother Mark? I think he got 5 points. All right, Pau. There we go. He's up to 3 points. Halfway to tying for first. And another good release. Misses that shot. Can he get up to 4 here? He needs to hit this if he wants to be in it. But he misses. So only at 3 points with only 4 shots. He needs to make every shot to win. But unfortunately, he misses up to 4 points in total now. Can he make it 5? He makes it 5 and 6. Perfect release. Pau Gasol is tied as well at 6 points. He straight killed it there as well. And we only have 4 more players left, up to Frank Kaminsky next. It's going to be so weird to see who wins this. They're all tied at 6. Frank up here. That was a terrible release. Let's redo that one. Another bad release. Come on. There we go. That's a good release. Got to get used to his jump shot. And Frank Kaminsky 0 for 2 on the first rack. Not starting off good here. Usually they hit one, at least one on the first rack. 1 point now though. Can he make it 2? Bad release. Still gets it to fall. He's up to 2 points. Almost halfway through this competition. That make that 3. And he hits 4 now. He might actually end up winning this thing. Let's see. He can only miss 1 more shot. And that was it. Can he still tie? Oh man, that was a terrible release. We got to redo that one. There we go. Good release there. And he misses it. So 4 points here still for Frank Kaminsky. Make that 5. And is he going to tie as well? No, he's not. So Frank Kaminsky at 4 points. We still have 3 tied people. At 6, and that's going to be Mike Muscala, Jason Smith, and Pau Gasol. But we do have Kelly Olynyk up next. He went off in the playoffs last year. Maybe he'll go off in this 3-point contest. Just needs to hit 7 shots. Bad release there. All right, there we go. Another bad release, but he does get that to go. Oh my gosh, that was terrible. Come on, give me a good release. 2nd shot. There we go. He hits that. Finally, a good release. 2 for 2 for Kelly Olynyk. Make that 3 for 3. And 4 for 4. Another bad release, but he still gets it. Kelly Olynyk is straight killing it. Make that 5 for 5. Can he get 6 for 6? No, he could not. He finally misses a shot here, but he can tie it all up at 6 right now. And he does with the bad release. He only needs 1 more shot to get 7 points. He does have a hot spot right here. Let's see what he can do. The final shot for 7. And Kelly Olynyk again. Another tie for 6 points. Every time somebody gets so close to winning and they choke it. He had 5 halfway through. And who's up next? We got Thon Maker and Maurice Spates. Somebody here has got to hit 7 points in order to win this thing. First shot is good. 2nd shot is no good for Thon Maker. See shot number 3. Slightly early. That one's not going to count. He is cold over here. Move up. There we go. Oh my gosh. Another bad attempt. Perfect release for Thon Maker. So Thon Maker is up to 2 points here in this 3-point competition. Can he keep hitting? Another bad release for him. Come on. Keep on going. Make that, three points now? Can he get 4? No. He misses that shot. So only 3 points here and only 4 shots left. He misses yet again. Can he hit 4 points? That was another bad release. There we go. Good release. But he still ends up missing. Thon Maker. 2 shots. And I think he's going to come in last place here. He is shooting very bad. Only with 4 points in this competition. Thon Maker is in last place. And now we got Maurice Spates. He has hit 7 points in order to win this. Let's see if he can do it. 1st shot is good for Maurice Spates. 2nd shot is good as well. 2 for 2. He needs to hit 7. That was such a deep range shot, but he still gets it to go. He is hot here as well. 4 for 4. No, he misses his 4th shot. So 3 points in total. And he misses another shot. Can he hit it here? No, he needs to hit his last four shots in order to win this. And he drains one. And the second one, he is up to 4 points. Two shots left here. At best, he can tie for first. Hits the fifth shot. And number six is good as well. So we have five players all tied for first. So we're going to have to find out who can actually win it. We got Kelly Olynyk. We got Pau Gasol, Jason Smith, and Mike Muscala. Let's see who wins. We're going to start off with Mike here. Let's see what he's going to do. We're only going to do five shots around it this time. See who ends up draining the most. Mike is 0 for 1. Okay, he hits his second shot. 1 point in. Can he get two here? No, he misses another shot. Two more shots left. He's going to have to do a bit better. That was way above the line. So we're going to have to restart that. And he misses yet another point. Still only 1 point for Mike. And he ends up getting two. So we're moving on to our next guy. 2 points is the spot to beat. Maurice Spates has to get two made shots here. I think Maurice Spates is going to be able to do it. Let's see, though. First shot for Maurice Spates. That is cash. So he already has one. Second shot is no good. Can he hit two here? There we go. He hits his second shot. Third shot is no good. He needs to hit one more to win this thing. That is a poor release. We got to do that again. Another poor release. Come on. No, that was a bad release again. Give me the ball. There we go. Good release. And he hits it. Maurice Spates gets 3 points. 3 points is the mark to beat now. Okay, so up next, we got Jason Smith. He has to get three on these boards here. We're going to start him off on the other side. Why not? Let's see what he can start off doing. First shot, he gets it to go. He might actually be able to win this thing. Second shot is a perfect release. This is to tie it for four or for three. He hits it perfect release. This is for four. He misses this shot. He's got to hit this one if he wants to take the lead here. And he does it. Jason Smith with 4 points there. We got two more competitors coming up here, though. So let's go next over to Pau Gasol, who actually did beat out his brother Mark, getting six. Oh my gosh, that was terrible. Terrible release. They're all so much different. Pau Gasol makes his or misses his first shot, so he can only miss one more shot, or he can't miss at all if he wants to tie for first here. Let's see what he can do. And Pau Gasol is going to be, I guess we might as well see if he can come second or third here. Bad release. Bad release again. Come on, give me a good release. There we go. Perfect release. He's up to 2 points. And now this is for three. But he doesn't get it. So Pau Gasol only with 2 points there. And we're on to our final player here, Kelly Olynyk. Can Kelly Olynyk get five made shots all in a row here? And he misses on the first shot. So he can't win it. But he can still come or tie for first. Or maybe even come second. There we go. Hits a shot here. In the middle now. Hits another shot. So he's up to 2 points. And he misses another shot. So he can't actually win this thing. And now his final shot. He's going to miss that as well. So our final leaderboards here, guys. Jason Smith surprisingly wins this competition. Then we got Maurice Spates coming in second. Then we had Pau Gasol in third place. Those are going to be our final ratings, guys. Leave your comment down below if you think it would turn out this way in real life or what you think would actually happen. Anyways, that's going to be it for this video. This was a pretty long one. But if you did enjoy it, again, smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're new. This has been your boy, Smeekle, and I will see you next time. Peace.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 M's in my back.